Hello, everybody. Welcome to Kholat. Well, I think at this game, I actually don't know how long ago this game came out, but from what I've seen, this is supposed to be one of the best horror games of 2015. Of course, I'm playing it in 2016, so a little bit behind, but I actually wouldn't have been able to play the game anyway until I actually got this graphics card. So, hey, by the way, I got a new graphics card, so hopefully this runs smoothly. It did post to say that Fraps crashes on occasion, so I really hope my Fraps doesn't crash, because that's what I'm using. If so, I'm screwed. So, I got in to make sure everything works, but we're going to get him for real now. And just before I start, this is awesome. This is weird. I don't know if this is supposed to be, like, the bad guy. He looks like a goblin or something like that, but I'm going to go ahead and get in it. And another thing, I love winter-based games. Like, y'all have probably seen my, what's it called? Long Dark playthrough. I'm loving that game, and this one's based completely in mountains in the middle of winter, so I'm pretty sure I'm going to love this one just as much. Here we go.
56 years ago, Russia, the northern Ural Mountains. A group of 9 students of the Ural Polytechnic Institute embarked upon a difficult winter expedition to reach the Otorten Mountain. Their journey seemed to progress according to plan. However, on the 7th day of their trip, the weather conditions worsened. They lost their orientation and were forced to set up a camp on the slope of the mountain called Kholat Siakal. It was their last stop. 3 weeks later in Yekaterinburg, when their families received no word of their success, the first rescue expeditions were sent. On February 25th, 1959, an abandoned encampment was found. The tent was torn down and covered with snow, with all the group's belongings left inside. Further examination revealed it was cut from inside out. The surrounding footprints indicated the crew had fled the tent. They were barefooted. This suggests a frantic escape, characteristic of people scared out of their wits. 2 sets of prints led to a forested area down the slope. The rescue team found an improvised fireplace and 2 bodies. They were lying in but their underwear, with cuts and scratches to their limbs, suggesting they had tried to climb the tree in panic. What could terrify them so much? The next 3 bodies were found scattered a few hundred meters from the first discovery. One of them had suffered a fractured skull, this despite no evidence of a struggle. It took the spring thaw, 2 months later, to enable the rescue team to find the rest of the victims. The last 4 skiers were found buried in a thick layer of ice and snow. Their autopsies led to even more bizarre findings. All of the bodies had severe internal injuries caused by an undetermined force, similar to that of a serious car accident. No external damage nor bruises were visible, besides a tongue ripped from one victim's mouth and a strange orange skin color. Much speculation arose from these puzzling events. Such theories included attack from the local tribesmen, from an avalanche, or animals. Each theory, however, only served to create more questions. The truth behind this tragic course of events remains unexplained to this day. What really happened? Maybe the answer still waits to be discovered, deep under the snow.
Okay then, I guess that's enough for the first part. That was a long intro. It was a good intro, like, very nice, but it was a long, long intro. Let's see what I mean about this game being beautiful, though. I don't know what engine this is made on, but also, music is really nice. But I'm not sure about that story. I've heard something like it similar in the past. I know what the game is based on, because it has been out for a while, and I've, of course, heard things. But that music is awesome. Like, I can't say enough about a game with a really good soundtrack. Like, that's another reason I like Skyrim so much. don't know if I've ever mentioned it before, but I love Skyrim, is that it's, I just love the soundtrack. I'll normally just listen to Skyrim soundtrack when I'm studying or something like that, just because it's such a good soundtrack, and this is a, it's like a calming, but it's like getting you ready for something, because it's like that calming but creepy at the same time. I'm just sort of aimlessly walking around, just sort of looking. This is going to definitely be a slower playthrough. I want to try to take in as much as I can. At least, from what I've seen so far, it's going to be slow. I'm pretty sure it's going to speed up later on, but I know it's supposed to be, like, open world-ish, where you're supposed to go to certain areas at certain times, but overall, I think you can go anywhere in the world. I think I'm supposed to go this way. But yeah, the one thing I'm curious is that these houses, there's people living here. Like, that chimney's going. Unless that chimney has a ghost inside it, there's people living here. Man, but y'all have no idea how happy I am to have a good graphics card. Because before, it would lag if I just moved my camera like that. So, I'm happy I have a good graphics card. But as far as, like, this goes, why not just knock on the door and ask the people about it? I don't know. Maybe you don't do that in Russia. Who knows? Russia is one of those places I want to visit, particularly, like, mainly the Siberian area, because of just sort of how wild it is over there. It's, like, one of the few areas left in the world that is, like, nothing but nothing, basically. It's, I'm a big hunter, and I'd love to go hunt some of the animals they have out there. They have, like, some of the largest pigs in the world. Like, I'm here in Texas. Texas think we have the biggest pigs. Siberia has these massive wolves, and it's getting cold. Yeah, it's funny playing this and playing Long Dark, because in Long Dark, when there's a blizzard, I'm like, oh, I need to get inside, whereas in this, there's no, like, actual health meter or anything, which I don't think that's going to take away from the ambiance of the game at all, or not the ambiance, but the I think it was just my eyes messing with me. I thought I saw someone walk behind that tree right there. I don't know why. But, immersion. Immersion in the game is what I was trying to say. And that's when the music changes. That's when you know you're starting to get into it, is when the music goes from being really nice to... Hello? Hey. Yeah, I'm in the middle of recording, Zach.
Oh, my bad.
It's okay. Sorry about that. Alright. Let's see. Doesn't look like this goes anywhere. Maybe this goes somewhere? Nope. Okay. Okay. I'm just gonna run back to the main path and go left, because apparently I can't go that way. So that's interesting, when you run, instead of, like, sounding tired, you sound cold. Which I guess that's pretty realistic. But... Ooh. Uh-oh. Further down you go, the creepier the music gets. That's always a good sign. Man, this is so cool. I'm a big winter... I don't like... I'm gonna go this way. This way looks nice and happy. That way doesn't. But... I'm a big winter guy, so any game that I'm, like, immersed in snow makes me happy. But yeah, I'm gonna save the scary, really scary part for later. Now, one thing I don't know is I don't know what, like, the not the bad guy is, but what the enemy is in this game, or enemies, if there are more than one. Like, I know, what's it called? PS Until Dawn had technically multiple enemies. Although in the end there was only one true one. Not to spoil Until Dawn for anyone out there that hasn't played it, or seen it played, I highly suggest you do, and I highly suggest you play it for yourself. I never have been able to. I've watched it played because I don't have a PS. And it makes me sad, but it's an awesome game. Awesome winter game. Of course I like it being winter, but I don't know if this one's going to be along the same... line where I have multiple things, multiple antagonists in the game, and trying to find out which one is the true antagonist. But there's nowhere else to go, so I... What the... Oh, that's... Those are footprints. Oh. They disappeared. Okay, I'm going for it.
Are you coming to me?
I guess. Oh god, it's getting... Uh-oh, no, 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 no. Get bright, get bright, get bright, get bright, please. Okay, so let me settle myself. Okay, here we go. Oh my god, this is so creepy. There's not a lot of things more creepy than getting lost in the middle of the woods during a snowstorm. I'ma call it that from now on. Oh, that wasn't so bad, I guess. What is... Oh, I'm going into a cave. Oh, okay. I swear, if it just... Whoa! I love when my lip just...
The only thing I saw was a flash. An insufferable burning light. The pain ripping apart my body. I felt it tearing out of my soul. After a while, I was nobody.
Oh, this is so cool.
Nothing. The light went out and I vanished into overwhelming darkness.
Oh, this is so cool.
I welcomed the end with delight.
Oh. Okay. So that sounded like an... That sounded like an alien abduction. Anytime I hear a flash of light, that reminds me of an alien abduction. And I know that's one of the things about Siberia, is there's been a lot of, like, UFO sightings out there. So that could be the basis for this. Oh, where are you? Oh, this is the campsite. Oh, I pressed E. I did a thing.
I am right behind you.
I don't trust you. Okay then. Let me just get really close to that. That compass started spinning. That means there's a disturbance in the magnetic field. I actually don't know what it means. I haven't taken physics. I think that's physics. I don't know. So far, so good. That was really creepy. Cool intro. And like, whenever I was actually in like that blizzard, the snow particles flying across my screen looked really realistic and really cool. I really liked that feature. Taking a long time to load, though. All right, but yeah, I'm like I was saying. I think it's alien based. I don't know. I actually didn't hear. I know it's like more ethereal. I think that's the word. Oh, I'll be quiet. That was Act One. Okay.
Have you ever tried to hold on to your humanity?
I tried.
Convince you of being no more than a subject, an object, which they can bend to their will.
So is this the Russian sleep experiment?
Monster that deserved punishment. And you could really not remember your sins when they took away your loved ones.
Where am I now?
To rot in the dark.
Oh.
The problem is, it's in their darkness. You have never been alone.
What is that in the distance on the right? Okay. I'm guessing I'm supposed to follow this. F1 for survival info. Okay. Alright, I'm just going to read this. I'm going to go by act, part-wise. So, I'm going to read this and then we'll finish it. Running left ship in deep snow is tiring. Adjust the pace to surrounding conditions so you don't exhaust your organism. What? What? Am I not human? I thought I was... Okay. Before setting off for a longer journey, rest in the camp and set a goal for a safe route. I thought I heard walking. You can focus on any object to take a better look at it, lighting the way with the flashlight. Y'all hear that, right? I think that's my tent. That may be the tent behind me. Okay, flashlight is F. Observe the environment for better navigation with the help of map and compass. Barely accessible rocky notches may lead to interesting places and shortcuts. To gain access to them, you sometimes need to squeeze through low-lying obstacles. Laybook? I don't know. Okay, diary. Oh. What? Okay, oh, that's that walking stick. Oh, crap, I lost this foot. Footprints. Okay, I wasn't done reading all that stuff. Okay, diary, reports, articles. Okay. I guess I don't have anything. And then this is survival. Okay. Alright. Well, this is awesome looking. Wait. Okay, there's the tent. Alright. So I'm just gonna look around this area real quick, and then we'll go ahead and end this part. It's about 16 minutes in. I'm not exactly sure how far, but about that time where we can go ahead and end it. And yeah, this is looking like it's gonna be an awesome game. Just look at this. How beautiful is this? Incredible. Okay, that's creepy though. Alright, but that's gonna end it for this part. I hope y'all enjoy it so far. I'm looking forward to playing this game. Nothing super spoopy happened except walking through some trees, but that's okay. So, I will see you all in the next video. Adios, amigos.